thinking I'm gonna have to go straight sword on this one. So I can get those faster swings out. Like, it's cool and all, but man, it's... Yeah. Actually, maybe I can scythe one hand. Yeah. I think one hand is the way to go. Because I want that faster swing from the roll. Alright, here we go again.
Thank you.
Man, I feel like my clone, the clone that they summoned to help me, I feel like he doesn't have the help one of Farron's clones. The Abyssal Watcher. Like, I feel like he doesn't have the clones don't have the same health. The clone that he summons that helps him has way more health than the one that he summons to help me. But it might just be that, like, they have the same health. It might just be that the one that he summoned to help me gets, like, double teamed by both of them. So, like, obviously his health drops, like, real fast. Such a weird like combination of moves he has. He has the dagger for lightning quick like slashes, and then like the greatsword for these giant leaping attacks. How do you even get up fast enough to hit me? Just waited till the Nameless King. Answer me this. The fight with the Nameless King, is it a 1v1? That's all I want to know. If it's a 1v1, I'm not fine. I'm looking. I mean, he's not supposed to help you, but he's there, and he just fights whoever is closest to him, whoever aggroes him or whatever. But I guess I got aggro in that last hit, man. He like sword uppercutting. Alright, so what I think I'm gonna do is I'm trying to go with the safe stat now. The safe strat. I'm gonna try to get some damage on him early on. Yeah. Try to get some damage on him early on. Then once the clone shows up, gonna pretty much just run around him in a circle until the other guy shows up. Then we can 2v2. About it. Part of me wonders if I should one hand the scythe and then just kind of like try to go for parries and stuff. I feel like parries and stuff work on them. Maybe they do, maybe they don't. I don't know.